Hello, algebra students. Mr. Laurence here. Two quick problems. This first problem is kind of like cluster number four, only it's three-dimensional instead of 2D. So we have this rectangular prism with dimensions of 3 meters. Ooh, I forgot my meters. Don't forget the meters, Mr. Laurence. And a quantity of x plus 5 meters and a quantity of x plus 4 meters. All right. So the volume of the prism above is 168 cubic meters. What are the dimensions of the prism? Well, we know that to get volume, we normally take the area of the base. That's what capital B is, area of the base. The base would be a rectangle, x by 5 times x by 4. And we'd multiply by the height, which in this case is 3. So I'm going to take area of the base, which I get by multiplying x quantity of x plus 5 times quantity of x plus 4, and then multiply it by the height. Remember, the volume of a rectangular prism can be found by doing capital B, which is the area of the base, times the height. I've said that several times. Do you think it's important? That will equal the volume, which I'm told is 168 cubic meters. So now I'm going to double distribute here, and I'm going to get an x squared plus 5x plus 4x plus 20, and then I'll have to distribute that 3. So I guess technically there's a 3 distributions going on, but that be that as it may, I'm going to make this 27x plus 60, right, equals 168. Now, I could have divided by 3 if I was really sharp paying attention. I could have said, hey, what about if I just divide both sides by 3 right here? I could have done that because 168 is divisible by 3. I didn't see it, so I'm going to do it this way. Now, to solve this, I need it equal to 0, right? So I'm going to subtract 168 from both sides. Okay, so I'm going to get a 3x squared plus a 27x. If you're wondering where that 27 came from, 5 plus 4 is 9. So it'd be 9x, and 9x times 3 is 27. And I believe this is going to be like a 92, right? Yeah, let's see here. 168 minus 60. Oh no, silly me. 108, yeah, silly me. 108, of course. So it'd be a negative 108. Now, remember, I've told you, GCF, GCF, GCF. I see a GCF in here. I do. I know that 3 goes into all three of them. 2 plus 7 is 9. 3 goes into 9. So 3 goes into 27. 1 plus 0 plus 8 is 9. 3 goes into 9. 3 goes into 108. So I'm going to factor out that 3. I get an x squared plus a 9x. I'm dividing by 3 in case you're wondering, in case I'm going too fast. And let me see, 108 divided by 3 is going to be 36. Yeah, minus 36. Okay. Now, this is not a perfect square trinomial. I'm going to need to multiply A times C. And A would be 1, right? A equals 1. C would equal 36. So I need two factors of 36 that subtract to get 9. Well, I'm thinking 12 minus 3. Yeah, so I'm going to rewrite this as x squared. Got a 3 out front, sorry. X squared plus 12x minus 3x minus 36 equals 0. Now I'm going to do my grouping on the inside here. I'm going to group those two. I'm going to group these two. And that's where I have to stick the plus in between. So I've got this 3 out front. Okay, I'm going to change that to a bracket. I'm going to GCF and x out of here. Get x times the quantity of x plus 12. And I'm going to factor out a negative 3. And I'll get an x plus 12. Yeah, there we go. All right. And then I'm going to have a 3 and an x plus 12. And an x minus 3, right? And so I have two possible answers for x. X could equal negative 12, or x could equal 3. I just solved x plus 12 equals 0, and I solved x minus 3 equals 0. That's what I did there. Kind of did them in my head because they were so simple. Now, if x is negative 12, there's a problem because my prism ends up with negative sides. Like this would become negative 7, and this would become negative 8. You can't have a measurement that's negative 8 units long or negative 7. All distances have to be positive. So I'm going to throw that answer away and assume that x must equal 3. Since x is 3, I know that x plus 5 is 3 plus 5, and therefore this becomes 8 meters. This is a 3, so I get 7 meters. So my dimensions, my length, would equal 8 meters. My width could equal 7 meters, and then my height would be 3 meters, and there you go. Piece of cake. Long problem, but not hard, not difficult. All right, try this one. It's not a volume problem. Why don't you pause the video, see what you can do with it, then come back and watch me. All right, the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to GCF it, and I know there's going to be a GCF of an x. There's probably going to be a GCF of those numbers there. So I'm going to list the factors of 12, 1 and 12, 2 and 6, 3 and 4, and I'm going to see, does 12 go into 40? Nope. Does 6 go into 40? It does not. Does 4 go into 40? Yes. Does 4 go into 68? I believe it does. My GCF is a 4x. So, now be careful here. Emily, I hope you're watching. Notice I wrote my GCF down. It does not disappear from the problem. So I get 3x squared plus 17x plus 10 equal to 0. Now, I'm going to factor inside here. I'm going to ignore this 4x. I'm not throwing it away. I'm just going to ignore it. Off to the side, maybe I'll write 3x squared plus 17x plus 10. And I'm going to multiply a times c and get 30. And I need two factors of 30 that add to get 17. Oh, how about 2 and 15? Yeah, if I see it right away, I don't have to list them all out. So I'm going to rewrite 3x squared plus a 15x plus a 2x plus 10. Now it's time to group. Only time you stick that plus in between is when you're grouping. When you're grouping. All right. So I'm going to factor out a 3x here and here. I'm going to get 3x times the quantity of x plus 5. And here I'm going to factor out a 2. All right. And get 2 times the quantity of x plus 5. And then I'm going to have the quantity of x plus 5 and the quantity of 3x plus 2. All right, so I have this 4x times the quantity of x plus 5 times the quantity of 3x plus 2. That's supposed to equal 0. So now I take each piece, 4x, set it equal to 0. X plus 5, set it equal to 0. 3x plus 2, set it equal to 0. And I'm going to solve for x. So x is going to equal 0. Subtract 5. X is going to equal negative 5. And subtract 2. 3x is going to equal negative 2. Divide by 3. Divide by 3. X is going to equal negative 2/3. So my solution set for this would be negative 5, negative 2/3. And 0. And there you go. All right, that's it for the video. No video quiz tonight. Mr. Laurence signing off. Have a good night, everybody.